Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about drugs, smoking and alcohol abuse. This topic comes under chapter Human Health and Diseases. It's one of the important chapter. At least one or two MCQs you always get from this topic in your NEET exam. So what you have to do, you have to watch the video till the end so that your concepts become clear with respect to drugs, smoking and alcohol abuse. Drugs, when we talk about the commonly used drugs, normally there are two types of drugs. One drug is prescribed by doctor and second drug is taken by own. So the one which is prescribed by the doctor, it becomes the medicine. But the one which is taken by own without taking the consent of doctor or concerning the doctor, then it becomes abuse. And the person who is taking it is considered as addict. This is called as addiction. The commonly abused drugs are, first we have opioids, second is cannabinoids, third we have coca alkaloids. So there are three different types of drugs. So in short, if you want to remember, just remember it as OCC. OCC, it is opioid, cannabinoids and coca alkaloids. The next one, how they interact with our body, how they react with our system. So since it is drugs, it will respond at two places. First, you take in the drugs either through mouth or through injection in the blood, intravenous. So if you take in through mouth, it is going to enter in your GI tract. So first, it is going to interfere with the receptors that are present in the GI tract. And plus, it is going to react with the receptors present in the brain. So what I can say, they bind to specific opioid receptors. There is a specific receptors present in a CNS, that is central nervous system, and in the GI tract, that is the gastrointestinal tract. The drugs which are included under this category is morphine, we have heroin, and we have brown sugar. So MHB. So MHB. Now here, you can see here there are receptors present. These receptors, they bind and the chemical enters in our body regulating the other genes. Now the point here is, look at this morphine. Morphine is a potential painkiller. The patients who have undergone surgery, for them morphine is given. But if you take morphine without any kind of surgery, then it is considered as drug addict. Then we have heroin. Heroin is taken intravenously, that is again a problem. Then we have brown sugar, it's a brown powder. Morphine, when we talk about morphine, morphine is extracted from latex of poppy plant and papaver somniferum. So there are two plants here, morphine. So remember, it is MPP, morphine, poppy plant or papaver somniferum. Look at the chemical structure. Most of the time in the exam, they show the structure and they tell you to identify this structure. So how you can identify? First, remember that there are four rings. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four rings with OH group and methyl group. So this four ring OH and methyl group can easily help you to understand the structure of morphine. We have the next one, that is the poppy plant. So in poppy plant, you can see that they have a latex which is secreted by the fruits. So this whitish fluid is the latex. Morphine is a sedative, it's a painkiller and it is useful for surgery. So doctors, they use morphine as a medicine, but a person uses it for drug addiction. Next that we have is heroin. Heroin is commonly called as smack, or even it is also called as diacetyl morphine. That is the other name for heroin. Love yourself and say no to drugs. That is the ultimate goal of this chapter. So heroin is nothing but white, odorless, bitter crystalline compound. It is bitter. If it is bitter, why we eat? Because it reduces the stress, or even it causes hallucination. It is obtained by acetylation of morphine. The morphine that we have seen just before this, that morphine has to be subjected to acetylation. And then it is taken. It can be taken in two ways, either by snorting through nose or directly injecting in the blood. It is a depressant. It will slow down your all body functions so that your body is not able to feel any kind of emotional stress. That is why heroin is used. So heroin is given at the time of surgery so that if there is any kind of pain in the patient, that will be reduced. Next drugs that we have is cannabinoid. It's a second group of drugs. They interact with cannabinoids receptors in the brain. Again, there is a receptor present in the brain, and that receptor is nothing but it is cannabinoid receptor. Generally, it is taken by inhalation. So you can just inhale through nose, or oral ingestion. You can even eat it. What are the different types of cannabinoids? So we have charas, ganja, hashish, marijuana. All these are different kinds of cannabinoids. So let's take a look in detail. Natural cannabinoids, they are obtained from inflorescence of plant, that is Cannabis sativa. Again, it is CC. CC is cannabinoids, Cannabis sativa, which is one of the hemp plant. Its flower, tops, basically leaves and resins, they are used to produce marijuana, hashish, charas and ganja. So what we are using here, we are using the flower tops. So the flower tops are used, even leaves and resins are used to produce such kind of drugs. The next part, they affect our cardiovascular system, very important. Cannabinoids, it affects the heart. It affects the cardiovascular system. Look at the skeletal structure of cannabinoids. So again, there is no ring. Remember, cannabinoids has only one ring and it is having two mountain. So this way you can remember the structure of cannabinoids. Cannabinoids are abused by some sports persons also just to boost up their stamina or to increase their blood flow. Next, we have cocoa alkaloid. That is the third group. Or even it is called as cocaine, which is commonly called as coke or crack. It is obtained from which plant? Cocoa plant, erythroxylum coca. You can see in the diagram, these are the fruits of this erythroxylum coca plant. And hey, what it does, it interferes with the transport of neurotransmitter. It means it never sends impulse to the brain. It's a depressant, it's dopamine. So the new dopamine neurotransmitter is not in function under the impact of this drug erythroxylum cocoa. Cocaine is usually snorted. It is taken through nose, as you can see in the image. The man is just snorting the cocaine powder. It stimulates the CNS. Your central nervous system is stimulated by producing euphoria and increase in energy. Excessive dosage of cocaine can cause hallucination. Hallucination means something that is not there, still you are able to visualize it. It is purely based on your visualization. It never exists in this world. Atropa, belladonna and Datura are hallucinogenic plants. These are those plants which causes hallucination. You can see in the diagram Atropa, belladonna here with the fruits, and we have Datura. Look at the fruits of Datura, you can understand. So cocaine, it stimulates your CNS, that is central nervous system. It is usually snorted. An example for this, we have Atropa, belladonna and Datura. They are also causing hallucinations. Drugs like we have barbiturates, we have amphetamines, we have benzodiazepine. It is called as BAB. Barbiturates, amphetamines, benzodiazepines, they are used in medicines to treat mental illness like depression and insomnia. Insomnia means where there is no sleep, the person is not able to sleep. But they are abused, resulting in impairment of physical, physiological or psychological functions. When a person is undergoing through rehab, that time barbiturates, amphetamines and benzodiazepine is given as a medicine. Insomnia means when the person cannot sleep. These medicines, they are abused, resulting in physical, psychological and physiological dysfunctioning. So remember, these are barbiturates, amphetamines and we have benzodiazepine. We all know about smoking and we have studied that smoking kills. But still, It is seen mostly in youth, where they are more prone towards smoking. So let's see the next one. Tobacco has been used by humans for over 400 years. So it has been 400 years or more than that when humans have been smoking tobacco. It can be smoked or it can be chewed or even it can be used as a snuff. It contains many chemical substances like tobacco mainly consists of nicotine, which is an alkaloid. It stimulates your adrenal gland to release noradrenaline hormone, which causes high blood pressure and heart rate. So remember, tobacco has very important role. It increases the blood pressure and it increases the heart rate. So tobacco smoking is injurious to health. Let's take the next part. When you talk about smoking, smoking causes cancer of lungs. It causes cancer of urinary bladder, throat, emphysema, lungs, bronchitis, swelling of the bronchi, there is coronary heart disease, then gastric ulcers. All this can be caused when you are smoking cigarettes. Tobacco chewing causes oral cancer, that is the cancer of the mouth. You can see in the image, there are various pictures available which says that smoking is injurious to health. Smoking increases the carbon dioxide content in blood that reduces the oxyhemoglobin. As a result, there is oxygen deficiency in the blood. It means the person can suffer from suffocation. Carbon monoxide and high carbon dioxide in the blood will reduce the oxyhemoglobin content. So this is all what you should know about drugs and smoking with respect to your NCERT. Thank you very much.